Hello everybody. Today we will discuss about a basic tutorial of LS-DYNA, impact of ball on the plate. So this is a very basic tutorial for all those who want to enter into the LS-DYNA world, who want to learn LS-DYNA from the basics. All right, so let's get started. So to make an impact, we need to prepare a FE model of plate and ball first. For that, we need to go to your shape measure. We will model your plate first. Using your shell elements, let's keep a four-noded shell. We need to specify the corners of your plate. These are P1, P2, P3, P4 are the corners of your plate. Let's have a first corner at a coordinate of your 0, 0, and 0. For your P2 would be your 100, 0, and 0. Third would be 100, 100, and 0. And fourth would be your 0, 100, and 0. Now this tell you number of elements across your X and number of elements across Y. Let's have a 25 element each side, 25, 25. And this is your increment. You wanna do an increment. This does not make any sense because we can directly enter your using your keyboard how many elements we want. Now the target name, let's give a name of plate, PID 1, element ID starting ID 1, node ID 1. It's nice. Let's click on create. This looks nice. Accept, done. Now we can see that 25 elements are present on each side here and here as well. Now we have to prepare a model of your ball. Let's go to shape measure. Again, we can go to your spherical shell. Let's have a radius of about 10 millimeter. Density, let's keep as 5 is. I mean, like this is looking quite less. We can keep it 2. Now this tell you center of your ball. We want to make it somewhere here. So coordinate would be around your 50, 50, and let's keep it 15. All right. The density is still looking less. We can keep it 1. Sorry, we can keep it as 5. This is quite nice. And the target name we need to change is to ball. Create, accept, and done. Now this is much nicer. Now we need to assign velocity to your ball. Go to keyword, go to your initials, velocity generation. Can select up PID 2 here, then we can click on your ball, then and we can give the velocity as 5.555. The negative sign is because your vertical direction Z is pointing upward. We need to supply velocity downwards, so negative sign is conveying that. Accept, done. Now we need to fix the boundaries of your plate, the edges. For that, go to keyword. Sorry, your create entity, your boundary SPC create. You need to select your area, then select the edges this way, and this way. Now you can click on apply. Now you can see here the X, these are first three are your translation constraint, the last three is your rotational constraint. We want to completely fix these nodes in your three-dimensional space, so all are checked. Now here we have a birth time and your death time. By default it's 0 and your death time is too large. We need to ignore it as of now. So now let's assign your material and section to your ball and plate. For that you need to go to your materials. Let's assign elastic material to your plate. Let's give a plate to 1, 1a minus 7. Let's have a modulus of point around, let's have 0.5, Poisson's ratio 0.35. Accept, done. For your Or let's have a section of your material of your rigid. Rho is your 1a minus 7. Sorry, 1a minus 7, but yet we have not given the title. Let's give a title: ball, modulus 210, presence ratio 0.35. Now the thing is that we want to constrain it or allow to move only in z direction. For that we will apply a material constraint here. One, we can select your constraint in your x and y direction. So x and y is here, constraint x and y displacement we can equal to 4. All right, then we can click on accept. Done. Now we need to go to sections. Section is your here, shell. Let's click ball and plate section. Let's have a thickness of 1 at each side. 1 section ID is 1. Click accept. Undone. Now we need to assign to your ball and plate. Your plate section is your 1. Material is your plate. Accept. Same for your ball. Section was already 1. Alright. Accept. Done. Now we need to define termination time for your simulation. Control termination. Termination. You go to 30. Alright. Click on accept. Done. Now go to your database and assign the time for your D3 plot. Let's have output at every 2 milliseconds. Accept. Done. Now the one main thing which we had not defined here is your contact. We need to define your contact definitions. Go to contact. Let's have automatic surface to surface. Let's have ball versus plate. We have a part ID for your slave and master. This is your slave type. 3, we can pick your plate. Here again, we can pick up your ball. All right. Let's have a friction value of 0.3, damping coefficient of 20. This is your damping coefficient. All right, we need to ignore this. Keep the value of viscous damping coefficient is here, VDC. Now this is much nicer. Other thing we need to touch here is your ABCD. Go to your soft value 2. This is 0.1 is nice. 0, 1.305. SBOPT should be your 3. Depth should be your 5. And let's keep everything as by default. All right. Accept. Now we can draw it also here. You can see now this is defined here. So this is done. All right, now we can visualize what we had defined. Display boundaries, SPC, these edges for your constraining your plate. Click on none, then contact. We had contact between plate and ball. Click on none, then initial condition for your ball coming downward. All right, we can look at your keywords again. Now this looks nice. All right, we had control, we have database. I think we are good to go to perform our simulations. Thank you so much. We can save it your K file. Going here, we can save as your keyword file. Then we can perform the simulation. Now, the post-processing part we will cover in another video. Thank you so much, guys, for listening. Keep commenting for any questions. Goodbye.